cause I be in the hood like an engine block. Dude, that rhetoric you spit, I ain't hearing it.
What's up, my people? This is Showbiz the Adult. All right, man, look. I truly think Manny Pacquiao and Errol Spence are going to fight next. And here's my early prediction of how that fight is going to go. But first, I want you guys, all you guys who are questioning if Manny Pacquiao really wants that smoke, I want you guys to try to consider this. Consider the mindset of a warrior. First of all, Manny Pacquiao, he doesn't have some kind of undefeated record he's trying to preserve. Manny Pacquiao, his legacy is cemented. Manny Pacquiao has a life after boxing. He's a senator. He also has money up the anus, okay? Why would he fight at all? Because he's a warrior, and that's what warriors do. Have you guys learned anything from Apollo Creed?
But you can't change what you really are. And you can forget all this money and stuff you got all around you, man, because it don't change a thing. You and me, we don't even have a choice. See, we're born with a killer instinct that you can't just turn off and on like some radio. We have to be right in the middle of the action because we're the warriors. And without some challenge, without some damn war to fight, then the warrior may as well be dead, Stallion.
He's a warrior. That's what warriors do. Now, you may think, well, why fight Errol Spence? Errol Spence is a beast. Didn't you see what he did to Mikey Garcia? That's how you think. That's not how a warrior think. Manny Pacquiao, if he's going to fight at all, is going to be against a huge challenge. That's what warriors do. A lot of you guys, no disrespect, were introduced to boxing through Floyd Mayweather. And Floyd Mayweather is the only Floyd Mayweather. You gotta think outside of Floyd Mayweather. You gotta think about how Henry Armstrong passed the torch to Sugar Ray Robinson. You gotta think about how Muhammad Ali passed the torch to Larry Holmes. You gotta think all the way down to Klitschko passing the torch to Anthony Joshua. See, that's what warriors do. They fight until the bitter end. If they feel that they have anything left, they're going to squeeze it out of themselves. That's what warriors do. And that's why the passing of the torch is a real thing. Manny Pacquiao ain't trying to fight Keith Thurman. Manny Pacquiao ain't trying to fight Sean Porter. That guy wants the man. But real recognize real, and to Manny Pacquiao, Errol Spence look extremely familiar right now. And Errol Spence, when he looked at Manny Pacquiao, he said, stand right here, right next to me, stand right here. You want that retirement check? I'm going to give it to you. Because Errol Spence is a real one, but he's a young one. He's a young lion. He's the next lion, and he has no problem. He has no problem giving Manny Pacquiao that retirement check. Now, this is how I feel the fight would go. I do not think it would go anything close to how Errol Spence and Mikey Garcia went. And here's why. Errol Spence was able to dictate the distance with great footwork, a very educated jab, and good head movement. Also, he used a straight left as a defense. You see, his straight left nullified a lot of things, and Mikey Garcia was a little bit hesitant to be aggressive. Manny Pacquiao has the experience of fighting a bigger man. See, this was Mikey Garcia's first time moving up to fight somebody at 147, a challenge like Errol Spence. Manny Pacquiao's been doing it his entire career. So the experience is different. So Manny Pacquiao is going to know how to get in there. He's going to know how to throw punches and bunches. He's going to know how to use his feet to hop side to side. He's going to know how to bait Errol Spence in to lunge in a little bit too much on his punches. He's going to know how to return with a great counter. He's going to know how to keep Errol Spence off his back foot by attacking with those power punches. See, Manny Pacquiao, he knows all those things. He got experience. And the last thing to go is his punching power. So when he catches Errol Spence flush, he's going to earn Errol Spence's respect. But I got Errol Spence winning this fight. I got him winning this fight. Not just because Manny Pacquiao is 40. not just because Manny Pacquiao was 40, but also because Errol Spence is a damn good boxer. He's a damn good boxer as well. What I didn't know, what I questioned, and he woke me up to, is he has good head movement side to side. And he knows how to counter very well. When Manny Pacquiao come jumping in, Errol Spence can use his IQ to counter Manny Pacquiao. Everybody was talking about it was brains versus brawn. Now we all know that Errol Spence, he got brains. So it's going to be his IQ that's going to help him very much in this fight against Manny Pacquiao. Now the size is going to help, but Manny Pacquiao know how to deal with size. His youth and his speed, that's definitely going to help because Manny Pacquiao, he's in his 40s now. But what's really going to do it is the IQ. That's what's really going to do it. Errol Spence's timing and his IQ, that's really going to affect Manny Pacquiao because Manny Pacquiao, his speed went down a notch or two. So it's going to be easier for Errol Spence to land on Manny Pacquiao now. Now in their primes, different story. But we're talking about the fight right now. So let me know what you guys think in the comment below. Do you think Errol Spence will defeat Manny Pacquiao? And do you think Manny Pacquiao really want that smoke? Because I do. Showbiz the dope. Real recognize, real big.
Listen to Showbiz.
I'm out.
Boxing.